This is the traditional style of Joule Thief with a coil that you have to wind. And this is a new one that I just made. It uses a different type of inductor, fewer parts, much easier to make, and can be made much smaller. So I will show you the experimental steps that I took to make this. Let's get started. Let's go over the parts list we're going to need. First is the LED, and I've already checked this one to make sure which side is negative, and I marked the negative side on here. Then there's the transistor, which is a 2N2222 or equivalent. And this is the negative lead over here, and this is the positive lead, and we have the flat side up here. So, and then the center one is the base. And these two things are the substitute for the coil. These are surface mount inductors. I got these out of an old router. I can show you where in the router I got them. And these will substitute for our coil. So let's go look at that router and see where these came out. Here's where I took one out. You can see it's labeled an FB402, and I've got it sitting back on there, but anyway, I just desoldered it, and that's what it looks like sitting there. Just an inductor. Sometimes they're labeled I for inductor, but in this board they're also labeled FB. There's a bunch of other stuff on here, capacitors, resistors. Be careful, they look very similar. But again, what you want is something either labeled FB or I for inductor. So the first step is to solder the LED to the transistor, and making sure that you get the negative lead over here attached to this negative lead, and then this positive lead to this positive lead. I'll go do that. I won't show all the soldering. I assume a lot of you know how to do that, and you don't want to see another lesson in soldering. But again, just make sure your parts are aligned, that the negative that I've got marked over here is attached to the negative lead on the transistor, and that the positive lead is attached to the positive lead. So I'll go do that, be right back. And here's what it looks like right before soldering. Make sure that my mark is lined up with the negative side. I've wrapped the pieces together so that they don't come apart when I do some more soldering down here. Here it is, the wrappings soldered, our legs are all soldered up. And what I'm going to do is, it's going to be easier just to show you. I'm going to go solder these on here and then I'll show you, but I'm going to put two of these inductors on here, and if the smaller ones don't work, I'm going to try bigger ones. So first start out with the smaller ones because I think they're going to work for me. I've soldered the inductors here on the back side. I want to show you the front side first. This is the flat side, and this is the collector, the positive lead over here, and then the center one. So we'll be dealing with these two, and when I flip it over, it'll be opposite, of course. So here's the positive lead, the collector, and here's the center lead. As you can see, I soldered one of those inductors onto the center lead right there, and soldered across over here and down onto another one, and it connects to the positive lead or the collector, and it makes a tent or an upside down V, if you will. They're not connected at the bottom, they're only connected at the top. And what we're going to do is we're going to attach our positive lead here and our negative lead over here. So if all goes well, it will light up when we do that. So here we are with our leads attached. Put some shrink wrap on this one because I was worried it might touch the center contact. And there's our inductors in place. So let's do it. Let's give it a test. I got the black wire hooked up. Let me hook up the red wire. And there we are. So there, yes, it works. Two surface mounts, inductors rather than a coil, and transistor and an LED, and that's all it takes. Well, I hope you found it interesting and useful in your Joule Thief experiments.